Hello. How's everyone doing? I'm sorry about yesterday. It's all Junior's fault, by the way, yesterday. That's crazy. Yeah, I know. It's crazy. Always Junior causing issues, but hi Taka, hi Mal, hi Junior. Hope you guys are doing well. Yeah, so today is gonna be more Ghost Trick. I'll try to go 4 hours. I think I have decent amount of sleep today. Yeah. Okay, fine. It's Junior's fault and Final Fantasy 14's fault. It's both. I know it's crazy, but oh, what? I owns your money? Yes, I own your money. Hey, Captain. What did Junior do to ruin Final Fantasy 14? Their players like Party Finder is full of juniors. He's scamming me. Hey, Rem. Final Fantasy 14 is full of freaking scammers, man. All the horror games you gifted isn't being played. One day. You know, Junior, I'm not surprised. I'm not surprised if you do. Not that I'm aware of, Taka. It's good to wake up early now. Look at me. I'm awake at like 6 a.m. So technically, being awake is a good thing. Loki! Just going to leave this here and head to bed? Loki, it's time to party. What do you mean? What are you doing, P9? You say that, Cap'n, but Noxie and Vitella already finished P9S twice last week and this week. They're going to learn P10S. The party's in the house. That's you, Loki. That's you. Hold on. Yeah, Captain. They already cleared it. They cleared it twice. And they won items. Yeah, you are, Loki. They got carried by Proto. Proto didn't even clear it yet. Hello? Nah, Mal, you gotta wake up for games, you know? Me, okay, I'm the party pooper. The biggest party pooper the pooper party can party. Oh my god. Sorry. Bad habit. Waking up early is a good habit. Ah, sorry. 10 a.m. is the earliest you can for gaming. I suppose 10 a.m. is doable. Oh, what's wrong? I'm dying. Literally got party with tanks that didn't know where the tanks fell and couldn't clear the first tank buster. That's why you go with Icky and stuff. I don't know, Loki, I'm just sneezing all of a sudden. Sneezing! Why are you still on Levin? Haven't you already, like, learned Levin or Limit Cut? Are you still struggling with Limit Cut? Baby Sandro! How are you? Allergies? I don't think it's allergies. Yeah, you're way past it now. Then clear it. There's nothing left. No, all you need to do is join a clear group. Like, within the next 4 days, it's your only chance to get a good clear group. Thank you, Loki. How are you, Bisandro? Are you never done? You okay? Enjoy vacation writing some good old sea code? That's not a vacation. A vacation is playing games, Bisandro. You can't join the group? What else are you struggling with? If you pass 11 strikes, there shouldn't be much left. Aragorn, how's your Valheim? No, never done. I don't know, Watcher Assistant is too scary for me, I think. You're looking forward to your vacation? Loki, do it. You deserve it. Yeah, I think the ship had sailed with Valheim. Did not? Just never made it? Made it where though, Captain? You're too vague. Made it where? Outlaw trials against multiplayer? Nah. Nah. I wish I never done all the time. Wunderland, how's your place coming along? Also, Chica, if you're interested, Remnant from the Ashes, the first game is on sale. I don't really want to buy games on PS5. Unless it's a physical copy. Loki, is that on time with Lies of P? Let me check. Why the key release? Oh, it's almost. Lies of P release date is on the 16th. I recommend that game if you're into Souls games, Loki. Oh yeah, Cassandra's really good at Valheim. It's time for your birthday, the day after. It's okay, Loki, see? 13th is your vacation. 14th is your birthday. 15th is your after birthday hangover. And then 16th is Lies of P. It all works out. That's the thing, we finally was a couple of people don't think. Yeah, the people who died of cracks is me. But, Kevin, however, Kevin, you still have to join Party Finder for clear. You're not trying hard enough, Bisandro. You're too busy collecting wood and rocks. Yeah, you're just living the life. Yeah, basically. Yeah, exactly, Loki. That's what it's all about. I don't think it's that, Captain. I think you just need more practice and keep going at it. Keep practicing. Alright. Continuing the story. Chapter 6. How many chapters you see in Tapa? 16? 1-6? And grow carrot. Good night, Loki. Thanks for hanging out. 16, if you recall, right? Alright. Junior, this game is 10 to 12 hours if you play it like a normal person. If you play it like Chica, it's gonna take like 24 to 48 hours. It's true, Captain. You don't play enough. Hey, Jerry. Long time no see. How are you? Ow, Cassandra. Ow. Lost memories of self, a forgotten murder case. A dead guy and a detective join forces to find out the truth behind them both. The detective assigned the dead guy a task to sneak into the prison and find out a certain prisoner's schedule for tomorrow. What should I care? I don't have a schedule for tomorrow. That's how I'm feeling about it at the moment. Well, time to go to the prison. I wonder how the detective who keeps dying is doing. I hope she's still alive. But bet she's pretty pleased with herself, keeping so much of the Reaper's attention focused on her. That little lady is waiting for her at the kitchen. Chicken kitchen. After I take care of this assignment, I better head there too. I bet she's gonna die. It's all over for me. Lynn, sweet cute Lynn, who shines as bright as the sun, ran away on me. And then those detectives, matching bookends, blue and green, yelled at me. Oh, forget about all that. Now you listen to me, kid. Yes, sir. Your bright as the sun Lynn probably doesn't even know you exist, and those detectives will probably yell at you for your whole life. Never mind fretting about every little setback. Enjoy your life. Get what you can out of it. Mister, would you mind just leaving me alone? Uh-huh. So how are the preparations coming along? I think they're taking care of them right now. Yeah? Man, I'm not looking forward to this. That kind of surprises me, coming from you. I didn't know you thought about such things. By the way, that was me being sarcastic, just in case you didn't catch that. 2 more hours, and then it's time. I guess we should just get back to work. Yeah, I guess you're right. I like how getting back to work is that guy playing cards, making a house of cards. The atmosphere sure seems tense. I guess I'll just get back to my work as well. I want you to go find out a certain prisoner's work schedule for tomorrow. Yes, the prisoners are given different job details every day. Each prisoner's schedule for the next day is written on the small blackboard in his cell. His prisoner number is D99. Alrighty then. How do I get to these cells? I better try to get some information here first. Hey Bailey. Try picking up your memos a little better next time. Let me see this thing. Inspector Prisoner C-74. Oh, it was almost time for that. I better prepare. Prisoner C-74, eh? What did that big whale do anyway? You don't know? About the Metro Police Department siege case? Metro who what? C-74 barricaded himself into the Metro Police Department and took siege of the place. He even pointed a huge flamethrower at the Chief Commissioner. Why the heck did he do that? That's what the detectives who surrounded him asked too. What are your demands? They asked. And? The guy looks confused. Thought about it for a while and said, bring me 5 servings of curry and rice on the double. Curry and rice? That's it? Unfortunately, no. After he was done eating, he torched the commissioner's office with a flamethrower, torched it good. Important documents and the commissioner's mustache were destroyed by the flames. What the heck did he do all that for? Because the curry was too spicy, he said. Huh? It was too spicy and he just lost it. Seriously? The case sent shockwaves throughout the country. But it doesn't make any sense. In the first place, how did a huge armed guy make it all the way into the commissioner's office alone? It's a complete mystery. What? Why don't they ask the C-74 himself? Maybe they did, but they haven't released anything about it. Apparently, it's all a matter of national secrecy. Huh. Captain! There's nothing on the throat, I haven't added it yet. There are a few things I want to add to the throne, for sure, but I haven't done it yet. Will you quit throwing my important duty memos away? Yeah, Captain. There are... some tracking-related stuff, for sure. Oh yeah, I got the Tanya model. I just haven't put her up yet. She's still in the box, but she's on display in the box. I have a problem opening stuff because I feel like if I open my Tanya model, I feel like her value drops. At the same time, leaving her in a box feels so bad. So I'm like conflicted. Like, do I open it? Do I keep it as it is? I don't know. Will you quit throwing my important duty memos away? Whoa. Ah. There you go again, fooling around with that thing. Why did it have bazookas? It wasn't me. Don't lie, you know, you love to see me jump up and prepare for emergency. Oh yeah, sure, way back when I first got this job. But I have enough of that now. Besides, you always react exactly the same way. The emergency switch is probably just loose, probably because I fool around with it so much. Well, it's for emergencies. Don't play with it. Anyway, it wasn't me. Maybe you ought to get it repaired, huh? Well, close it back up. It's making me feel on the edge. Nah, too much of a pain. A pain? Proper emergency procedures are a pain to you? What a sad, sad state of affairs. Ghost Trick available in Nexus? That's a good question. Let me check real quick. I actually don't know, to be honest. To be honest, I don't know. Oh, discount code. I don't think so. Not that I'm aware of. So We have sent you an email with details on how to confirm this site. And oh my god. I hate websites that overdo their freaking security. Oh my god. Oh, did you sign in from here? Did you sign in from there? It's like, please verify your sign in. Oh, check your phone real quick. Oh, click number 82. Okay, and then this, and then that. And I'm like, oh my god. Anyways, let me see. Library. Ghost. Oh, yes, Ghost Trick is actually on sale here. Wow. What do you know? But no discount though. Oh my gosh, why am I sneezing so much today? It's always three. Hold on. Ghost Trick. Add. Oh! I didn't know Ghost Runner was here too. Unfortunately, there isn't no. At least not from what I can see. But yeah, I added Ghost Trick. Thank you for reminding me. I gotta go through. Thank you, Captain. Yeah. Shows rows of tiny rooms. The rooms are really, really small, and you can see right into them from the outside. I suppose the open bars keep the rooms airy, but I wouldn't want to live in one myself. I wonder where these little rooms are. Hey, Bailey. Paranormal site, is that available? I don't think so. Yeah, paranormal site is not. Paranormal site is that game. The high mobility tree is getting the normie somehow. Hearing people say it's an anomaly because there's no microtransmission. How is that an anomaly? That is the way it should be. Hello? What's the matter? You can't even pin up a memo properly? Let me see this thing. Take prisoner C38 to the telephone room. Yes, he just made a request to use the phone a while ago. You already told me that, Alice. C38, eh? What did that punk do anyway? You never heard the story? About the secret rendezvous? Case? Secret who what? C38 was a singer in a band. His group was playing a concert that was being broadcast all over the country live. And right in the middle of their encore, there was a huge incident. A huge incident? What was it? A murder or something? In a way, It was even worse than a murder because it had to do with national secrets. National secrets? A rock band? I'm lost. The song they were singing was called The Secret Rendezvous, but the lyrics C3A was singing were completely different from usual. So I was in a huge incident because the new lyrics exposed all the nation's dark, seamy secrets. Bunch of misappropriations, foreign economic strategies, illicit dealings, everything. He was caught red-handed in the act of leaking national secrets. Seriously? The case sent shockwaves throughout the country, but it doesn't make any sense. In the first place, how would a rock singer know any top secret information? It's a complete mystery. What? Why don't they ask C3A himself? Maybe they did, but they haven't released anything about it. Apparently, it's all a matter of national secrecy. Huh. Why would you quit throwing my important beauty memos away? Hey, Billy! Let me see this thing. Bring dinner to prisoner D99. Oh, there we go. The chef is preparing it for him right now. Oh, how fancy. D99, eh? Even I know about this one. Yeah? Such a sad case. Hard for us, too. He shot his wife, didn't he? Right in front of a family member. It's just awful. Why in the world did he do it? Why would he do something like that of all people? The motive, everything, all a complete mystery. It's just ridiculous. It doesn't make any sense that he would do anything like that. I don't know the details, but apparently this case is a matter of national secrecy as well. I don't get it. None of it makes any sense. You do know what kind of prison this is, don't you? It's a special prison built just for these kind of special cases. That's D99. Who knows what he's thinking, or hiding behind that beard of his. I don't like any of it. I knew I couldn't take my job seriously without it getting to me. So the prisoner I'm looking for, D99, was convicted of murder, and he apparently has a beard. Oh, well. Will you quit throwing my important duty memos away? Okay. It's time. Oh, it's the music guy. He puts a wine glass on the house of cards. Nice. Microtransaction are a gateway to more egregious microtransaction. Look at the origin, aka hot offer. Listen. Microtransaction is something I would succumb to if I play Mahjong Souls anymore. It's a good thing Mahjong Souls don't have Haruna's skin for sale. If it is, I might actually do it. Just saying. I'm guessing that's the kid they were talking about. The one who sang the national secret. If he's a prisoner, he must have come from the cell. Oh. So this is the thing that was making that horrible noise a second ago. I guess it's a way for this spiky-haired youth to express himself. Sentiments like, I'm hungry or I'm thirsty maybe. Something primitive like that, I bet. Peace out. I'm done. Alright, C38, back to yourself. Hey, guardman, how about giving me a little space? That's crazy walk. I mean, that crazy walk of yours is dangerous, man. A proper walk for a properly led life. Now let's go. Yo, no lectures, man. I walk my own path, my own way to my own music. Oh, it's the beard guy. So I finally made it to the cells. Now to find prisoner D99 and check out his work schedule for tomorrow. What could Lynn possibly want with that information? Damn! Don't think I can take another second in this stinking pit. Looks like Guardman is gone. All this waiting is wiping me out. Hope this one will finally do it. Come on, sausage head. Sausage head. Huh. This prisoner obviously isn't the one I'm looking for. D99 has a beard. There's one of those little blackboards Lynn said would be in the cell. Maybe I should check out Spikey's schedule for tomorrow. There's a pad of notepapers hanging on the wall. There's a red O drawn on each one. I think it's some kind of letter or symbol, but I don't know, recall what that means. I mean... yeah, I like the art style here too. I like the 2D art style, I don't like the 3D. There's a pad of notepapers hanging on the wall. There's a red X drawn on each one. I think some kind of regular symbol, but I don't know what it means. So this is one of those little blackboards Lynn mentioned. Let me just give it a little read. Tonight, I lost a lot of things. My life, my memory. But there's a certain skill I've apparently lost too. I can't read. I can't see that there's some... I can see that there's some kind of writing on the blackboard, but I have absolutely no idea what it means. If I can't read Prisoner's D99's work schedule for tomorrow, what do I do now? Wow, I can't read? Well, that's great. This telephone. It looks like it has an internal line only. It doesn't call outside the prison. So the only places I can go with this telephone are other phones within the building that I've already possessed. So it would seem... but what happens if I press it? Huh, emergency button. An emergency in a prison. That's gonna be a pretty bad situation. I'll just give it a little try. What's going on? Hmm. What did I do? What's with you all of a sudden? What do you think of my quirky behavior? Surprise? Huh? You seem bored, so I just sort of wake you up. You can call that my gotcha move. What do you think? If a normal person pulled a move like that, sure, I might be startled. But this is you we're talking about. Oh, okay. How can you be so insensitive? I was only trying to open up a communication between us. I thought, do your work, Bailey. What a tease. What is happening? Oh, I think I know what to do. Oh, wow! Okay. So that's why he saw such shit. From the police department's siege case. But never mind that. Where did he just come from? What's going on in his cell? Anyway, there's a little platform here too. Just to be safe, maybe I better check the curry lover schedule for tomorrow too. Which I can't read it, so what's the point? I still can't read. But I better go check out the prisoner D99 cell anyway. Maybe I can find some kind of information that might help Lin out. Besides, I want to see what this prisoner Lin is investigating looks like. Do we need a sensor his head? Why? Oh, no. Oh no. No! Okay, we got the phone now. Same thing here. It looks like this is just an eternal phone on a hill. Doesn't call outside. So the only place I can go from this telephone are the other towns within the building that I've already possessed. Which means I can go up a row. Okay, good. What a strange cell, and the prisoner inside it. He seems to be enjoying himself. This is the last cell in the area. So that means that this man humming to himself must be prisoner D99, according to what the guards say. Even I know this one. Yeah, He shot his wife, didn't he? Right in front of a family member. Is that a Pringles mascot in the bag? I mean, I see it. What in the world really happened, and why is Lynn so concerned about this prisoner? I don't know the answers, but I guess there's no need for me to know. I have only one objective, and that's to find out what the painter's work schedule is for tomorrow. I can't read! Photos, eh? I wonder if these are of his family. This one looks like a young woman holding a baby. Their faces have been blotted out with black paint. Did he do it out of hatred or some kind of other emotion? Thankfully, that's not something I need to know right now. Oh, man. So, the work schedule for tomorrow of Prisoner D99. The information Lynn's looking for should be written on this blackboard. Unfortunately, I've lost the ability to read. But here I am anyway. The least I can do is take a look. Huh, what could this mean? There's nothing written on the board at all. I think something was written on the blackboard of the other prisoners, but this board is as clean as and blank as the day it was hung here. So I have the answer Lynn was looking for. Tomorrow's work schedule for Prisoner D99 is nothing. Would this information mean anything to her? It's not up to me to know or care. That's how I feel at the moment anyway. Not being able to read. I was wondering how this was going to turn out. Some things in this world can be read, even if one can't read. D99's work schedule for tomorrow is blank. I better get this information. Important information to Lynn as fast as I can. So, we're going to the chicken place? D99, dinner! Oh. Quite a feast tonight, I see. Ah, and I'm absolutely crazy about this chicken. It's too bad it's all cold and hard, though. I'd say it's been about 2 hours since it was cooked, judging from the way it feels. D99? I know it's kind of pointless to ask now, but just the same, I still want to know, why did you do it? I agree, it's pointless to ask now. My case is colder than this chicken, and has been forgotten by everybody, myself included. Detective Jones. Now then, let me eat in peace before it gets too cold to cut. Wait, so this guy's a detective? There's one more thing I've been wondering for a long time. What's that? Who is the man in that painting? Oh, this? Well, being in prison like this, you start to forget faces, you know? So I paint the faces that I don't want to forget. And this is the last of those faces. Oh, what? Why is it me? Now, could you leave me alone for a bit? Let a man eat in peace. Okay, sure. Sorry to bother you. What's going on? What in the world? What in the world could this mean? Why is there a painting of me in this man's cell? Who exactly is this prisoner? The man whose case Lynn is investigating is painting a picture of me in his cell. I have to go see Lynn, back, and not for her sake, for mine, to solve this mystery of me. I'm so confused. This telephone key doesn't connect to the outside. And I've got questions I want to ask Lynn. I gotta get to the place that has an external line, and fast. I never played it. This is the headquarters. What's the status over there? Oh, Chief, it's you. They're making preparations now. No problem, sir. How much longer then? 1 more hour, sir. I see. Carry on then. Oh, one more thing. Inspector Campanella wishes to speak with you. Evening. Campanella here. How are you boys doing? Inspector Campanella. Fine, sir. You got another little call tonight, didn't you? For my baby? From Lynn? Well, yes. Did my girl have anything interesting to say? Not especially. She hung up almost immediately. I see. Next time she gives you a buzz, be sure to let me know right away. That's a good fellow. Yes, sir. You tried to cover it up, and I'm sure you'll regret it very much. Very much. Yes, sir. I'll call you right away, sir, immediately. Don't forget, she's a fugitive after all. Yes, sir. Carry on, then. I might pop in a little later. Yes, sir. Looking forward to seeing you, sir. Lynn should be heading for Chicken Kitchen now, but the call from police headquarters intrigues me too. It's looking pretty obvious right now. That white suited inspector suspects Lynn, and she's considered a fugitive. This is not good. Wonder if I should go check on the chief and the inspector in white too. Inspector Campanella seems to be looking for her too. Yolene, I mean. Inspector Campanella? What would the Special Investigation Unit want with Lynn? I don't know. I guess something happened that we don't know about. Tonight of all night. Inspector Campanella must be upset tonight too. Were he and Detective 99, Detective Zhao, good friends? You sure about that? If they were such good friends, how come Inspector Campanella never came to visit him? He's the head of Special Investigation. He's a very busy man. Oh, but what's wrong? John was my hero, you know. I wanted to be a detective because of him. But look at me. Rotting away in a place like this, and I can't even do anything to help Lynn. What am I doing with my life? This is a new side up for you. It's kind of endearing. Anyway, the next thing to do is work at fixing what you can, little by little. Like, for example, your house of cards. It collapsed, you know. That back posture. So we'll go to the chief office, I suppose. Reverse shrimp pose. He's not a gamer. Preparation seems to be going smoothly over at the prison. Hey, Inspector Campanella. We were just a little too late. So close, huh, Inspector? We still have a little time left, Chief. Not much, but some. We've had Point X surrounded all night. If he shows up, we can nab him, and we can still make it. By the way, what's going on with the other case, the junket murder? She did it, huh? No question about it? She's a bad little baby, disappearing from the scene like that. Wonder where she ran off to play. What did he just say? She did it. Did I hear that right? I think they were talking about the culprit who killed me. No way. I just don't believe it. Why would she do something like that? Afraid I don't have the answers for you, Chief. I don't want to believe it any more than you do. And yet, after seeing this, maybe we don't have any other choice but to believe. Is that the security camera tape the investigation unit just delivered? I can't deny. That's some pretty solid evidence against her. Evidence. Nothing like it, baby. Why a murder case now on such an important night? Testis, I think you have it wrong, Chief. A murder case now, for the very reason that it is such an important night. Can't reach. Oh! Before I go find Lin at the chicken kitchen, it sounds like there's an important piece of info here I shouldn't miss. Pretty solid evidence, he said. This I have to see. But it's funny. Why do I have a bad feeling about what's on this tape? I don't know. Tell me. The junkyard where I died had a security camera, and it captured the moment of my death perfectly. And what the tape showed me was the cruelest truth imaginable. Weird, but okay. I saw myself shot right before my own eye by Lin. There goes my only lead. I feel like I've died all over again. One thing sticks with me though. Lin looked so surprised on that tape. Why in the world did I tell her? The truth is the truth. No matter how many times you watch it, Inspector Campanella. It wasn't me who played that tape just now. Oh, by the way, Inspector Campanella, there's something on that tape that troubles me. And what's that, Chief? I'm all ears. I had a look at all the photos of the crime scene as well, but... The place where the victim was shot and where the body was found is clearly different. Hey, he's right. That is strange. Didn't my body get pushed down from the top to the bottom? The hitman in black is the one who kicked me downstairs, but I changed his face. So he should have been out of the picture. But there I am, down on the lower level. I have the answer to your mystery right here, a few minutes after the murder took place. Oh wait, what? Is that a black cat? You got it, a furry feline messed up our crime scene. And then the little cat culprit vanished into the night. Huh, it looks like my destiny of being knocked downstairs is very hard to alter. This is Point X, come in, Chief. The Chief here. Did he show up? No sir, not yet, but... Idiot, I told you to stay off the radio unless it was important. But this is important, sir. Somebody else showed up. Our rookie detective, Lin! What? You see my baby over there, do you? I heard she was on the lam? What do you want me to do, Chief? What do you say, Inspector? Detective, get my baby away from Point X. Do it now, man, and then hold on to her. Yes, sir. I'll go get her now, sir. What's the meaning of this? Why would Lin show up at Point X? It took the Special Investigation Unit 6 months to pinpoint that location. Don't know, Chief, but I'd say it wasn't a coincidence. Perhaps. Well, what happened? Detective, come in. Now what? What happened this time? Damn it. This calls for a telephone call to point X. Allow me. Well, looks like we're getting to that phone. What are you doing? Get your buns over here. But what did you say? Now I finally understand. I finally know what it's like for our poor hungry customers who have died with their food delivery delayed. Excuse me? But this is the chicken kitchen, is it not? What? Aren't I talking to the police? The police? Did something happen there you need assistance with? Something happened here, you ask? Well, like, there's nothing left here. I gotta go. Wait. Wait, what? What's going on? Something, that's what. Something is definitely going on. And that something is far from nothing, that's for certain. Thanks for the tea, Chief. I'll be on my way. You're going to Point X? Point X, eh? I'll leave that to the boys. There's someplace else I gotta be. Inspector. Your being there isn't going to change anything. Why put yourself through it? I have a responsibility and I'm going to see it through to the end. Besides, it's not quite over yet. Right, that's true. Do what you must then. Prisoner D99 schedule for tomorrow was blank. It seems like forever ago that I found that out. And now my mind is even blanker than the Blackford Woods. Lynn, my only lead, and my partner shot me. What did it all mean? I knew where I had to go to get my answer. The chicken kitchen, the Point X the police have surrounded, and the place where something big just happened. What will Lynn be involved in this time when I find her there? Dun, 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 dun. So that was chapter 6. So it's about an hour a chapter. About. Yeah, this story is getting more convoluted. I thought it was just a simple story. And then it's like, hey, here's a little curveball real quick. And another curveball real quick. And oh, did I say a curveball? Here's another one. I mean, I suppose it's 12 hours if people play it the way it's meant to be played, like not read out continuously. Is it so many twists? I mean, there are twists, but I don't know if there's too many twists. Let me see real quick. Dun, 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 dun. Hey Rico, how are you? How are you? Peanut. Me too. I just can't get the images I saw at the police headquarters out of my head. The person who shot me tonight is the last person in the world that I want to believe did it. Now I'm here at the place she and I agreed to meet. The restaurant the police were staking out as Point X. But when I got here, I found the place in ruins. Hmm. What the hell happened here? Wow. Thanks for reading my thoughts, game. Whoa, what in the world happened here? Yeah, Riku, same. Same, same. Oh, the heaven. What do I do? If I had known something like this would happen, I would have paid the poor child more. I would have cooked more chicken for her. I would have sung to her as much as she'd like until she had her fill. Actually, about the singing, she did tell me she had her fill a time or two. The chef seems to be in quite a panic. Does it? Anyway, at least it doesn't look like the waitress is dead. That is true. Is that his head under his hat? Maybe. According to the police radio conversation I heard, Lin should be here, but I don't see her anywhere. It seems like bad luck has it in that redhead. So I was half expecting to see her in trouble again. I spotted the corpse of the van driver. No, she's dead. She's crushed here. Look at me, I'm dead. What took me so long? Huh? Well, that's one way to greet a guy. What happened here? Wait, how should I know? I'm the victim. Is it just my imagination, or is she getting more and more brazen every time she dies? Oh, that's because I'm a detective. I have to be tough, you know. Well, and how did it go? Did you check out tomorrow's work schedule for Prisoner D99? Yeah, just like I promised. Actually, I have a few questions I want to ask you about, too. Sure. I agreed to use each other after all, right? Okay, let's swap info then. D99's work schedule. Just like you said, each prisoner had a little blackboard himself. But the thing is, there wasn't anything written on D99's blackboard. It was blank. What? I guess maybe it means his schedule for tomorrow hasn't been decided yet? I think he's just gonna be sentenced to death. Yeah, because there's no reason for a work schedule anymore. Because he's gonna die. Is what I think. Blank? No. Yeah, that face. Huh? I didn't think she'd lose it over a blank blackboard. How come you're so upset about an undecided work schedule? I get the feeling that back when I was alive, I never had much of a schedule to worry about myself. Do you know what it means when a prisoner doesn't have a schedule for the next day? It means something? It doesn't mean he doesn't have work to do, it's more like he can't work. And that's because he's going to be executed. Executed? I see. Fate is trying to kill her? Kind of. Do you know what Prisoner D99's crime was? I think so. They said something about him murdering his wife right in front of his family member. That's what they say, but it's not true. He would never. Detective Joe would never do anything like that. Is she his daughter? Is that what's going on? And the death penalty hasn't been enforced in this country for a very long time. Not for decades. Even if the prisoner wants it. Like in this case. The prisoner wants it? There's definitely something else going on with this case. I just know it. And I have to find out what. And if his work schedule is blank for tomorrow, I have to do it right now. So this prisoner D99, Detective Joe, he must be connected to me in some way too. After all, he obviously knows me. On my way here, I stopped by the chief of police office. Oh, it was just on your way, was it? And while I was there, I saw who did it. I saw my murderer. You saw him? Where? How? not him, her. There was a security camera set up there at the junkyard where I got shot. The security tape showed the person who shot me. It was you. No way. You're kidding, right? What do you have to say for yourself, detective? It wasn't me. I didn't shoot you. If I recall, this is what you said about who shot me. My memory just isn't clear on that part. So how can you say for sure that it wasn't you? But because, I told you before, you were supposed to give me some information. Information, huh? Maybe that information was the reason you shot me. What? What do you mean? You said you had information on the case I'm looking into. So I would hardly shoot you before I even heard that information, right? I agree. That wouldn't make sense if it was before. Huh? But what if it was after you already gotten the information from me? I definitely told you something then. No, I think he said the murderer was me. It's like, the one who killed the one who put your detective Joan in jail was me. And then she's like, no. I was like, yes, it was. And then you're like, you monster. And then she shot him. Has to be. Whatever it was, it really shocked you. What did I tell you? I don't remember. I don't know. You've got to believe me. After you saved me, I thought I got all my memories back. But maybe I really didn't. You told me something. I can't remember that part at all. You got the information and you wanted from me, and then you shot me. Isn't that what happened? No. No, I didn't shoot you. Please tell me. What did you tell me that time? What did I learn from you? The police was taking this restaurant out tonight. They called it Point X. Point X, huh? That's a good name for this place. That white suit inspector was surprised to find out you just casually waltzed in here. Inspector Cavanella? Why in the world made you pick this place anyway? I guess I'd have to say because of you. Huh? Me? You remember that note I found? Yeah, I remember. That note that I didn't get a chance to read. It had a place and time written on it. The chicken kitchen. 10 o'clock. In other words, I was supposed to meet somebody here tonight? Yep, apparently so. I just had to get the information you were going to give me. That's why I came here. It was the only lead I had left. And this here is Point X. So that must mean the mark the police were waiting for was me? So what are you going to do now? I mean, you fulfilled your goal, right? You found out who shot you. Are you going to get revenge? That would be easy enough to do. All you have to do is not save me. Is this the ending I was hoping for? Is this the answer I was hoping for? Can I unravel all the mysteries of me? What am I going to do now? I'm going to save you, that's what. You are? I want to know everything. Who I was. Why I was killed. And I'd like to know who those guys are too. I want answers, and I'm going to find them. But to do that, I'm going to need your help. Okay. I won't say thank you. Not yet. And I won't say I'm sorry either. Well, help me see to it that you get your answer. Good. Now, I think it's time to go back to the past. I can't leave you lying flattened under a huge chunk of chicken forever, after all. Four minutes before death. The note says, the chicken kitchen, 10 o'clock. I wonder who that pointy-haired man was going to meet here. Oh, was that truck supposed to kill the pointy-haired man? What's this? Here you go. Where's my chicken? There it is. Can I eat that thing? Sure you can. Wow, she saved that girl and she died. Sad days. Maybe, Captain. You're just going bigger and better with each new death, aren't you? Leave me alone. Can I help it if I got tired of dying the usual ways? Well, I'll say this. It was a death any detective could be proud of. Huh? What makes you say that? The way you saved somebody else before dying yourself? Oh, that waitress? The one with the chicken on her head? The next time you put a chicken on your head, you should try one of the sides of the waitresses. I'll make a note of that next time. But anyway, if you hadn't tried to save that waitress, you'd still be alive. I couldn't help it, you know, the detective king thing and all. I wasn't able to save that poor van driver, though. At that speed, he must have died instantly. Well, we can't let a heroic detective like you stay dead. The root of this whole disaster is clear. The only question is, how do I stop it? Okay, let's get started. If only she looked up, she did look up! If you're gonna call me anything, at least try to make it my name, Sissel. Sorry about that, I'm really bad with names. The future of this lady's career as a detective is looking pretty bleak. It's no use, I can't read what it says. Let's see. Oh hey, I remember what that sign says. If you would like some water, please ring the bell 3 times. 3 times? Yeah, the waitress doesn't bring any water if you only ring the bell once. She said, those are the rules apparently. I said apparently? What do you mean apparently? Don't you work here? Why the stickler for the details, this detective? You wrote this note, right? I think so, but I don't remember. 10 o'clock? That means it's already time for your meeting with whoever it is. Now that I think about it, whoever you were supposed to meet might already be here. You're the detective, shouldn't you have checked that when you got here? Oh yeah, sorry. The chicken at this restaurant is really good, so you know. Haha. No, I don't know. Maybe we should take a look around the rest of the restaurant. There's nowhere else I can go. Hey, we can't hear what they're saying. Don't yell at me. Apparently, we ghosts can't hear conversations that are too far away. If we want to hear what they're saying, we have to get closer. What? But I want to hear what they're saying. Yes, those two are definitely suspicious. Huh, I was supposed to meet somebody here at this restaurant. Or maybe it wasn't so much a meet, but more like something else? Huh, yes, Sissel. If all goes well with our deal tonight, we will have the power to change the world, sir. Yes. It's a very important night indeed, my good man. We can't afford to make mistakes. A deal? I wonder what it's all about. I wish I knew. But those two are definitely worth checking out. Worth checking out? Oh, I think I know what I need to do. I'm gonna have to ring the bell. So then the waitress comes with the trolley, and I go to that chicken, and I'll go up to the top floor, and once I'm at the top floor, I can hear the conversation. That has to be it. You rang? Oh, I like her freckle. Huh? Oh, sorry, I didn't ring the bell. Oh, okay, I get it. This was a little big, wasn't it? Kind of like, hey, where's my food, right? No, not at all. Besides, I didn't ring it. Oh, okay, that's alright then. But the chef is the one who makes the chicken. No sense in harassing me about it, right? Just keep that in mind, okay? Odd girl. I agree. Me too. Ring again. Oh yeah, I need to ring it 3 times. Huh. What's taking my chicken so long? Unfortunately for you, according to what we saw before, the van arrives before your chicken does. In any case, just hanging around here isn't gonna fix anything. I'll just have to look for a way to get beyond this area. What the hell? How? How did I ring it 3 times? Huh. That waitress isn't coming. I wonder if I got carried away with a little with the bell. I don't know. It looks like you're not the only customer in here though. The waitress is probably just busy right now. What? You wrote this note, right? I've seen this. He should be here by now. Doesn't he know the first rule about making a deal? Never keep the customer waiting. Be quiet for a minute. There's a bug in this restaurant somewhere. A bug? I don't see any bug. Right there. A ladybug. I just hate little bugs. Huh? Thank you.
What does it do?
What the?
I don't get it. I say we should check out those two of the small. Call it a detective's hunch. Or maybe we can call it just plain nosiness. Anyway, I guess we should try casting a wider net and see what other info we can get. What? I can't even click the bell! What the hell? She's pretty, really? I'm pretty sure they see it. Oops. I only can click it once. I know it's about calling the water, but how? I'm lost. It doesn't matter. I don't get it. Oh, I have to tap it 3 times? Oh my god. Do you want more water? Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't ring the bell. And what's with the more water bit? Oh, well, come on. This is your 3rd glass. Oh, okay, I get it. This was a little thick, wasn't it? Kind of like, hey, where's my food, right? No, not at all. Besides, it didn't ring it. But I would like to see you bringing my chicken soon. You'll know it. In the meantime, enjoy a nice glass of water. Oh my god, okay, there we go. Check that out. That's so dumb, Captain! This is one big trunk. It seems pretty heavy, too. It's very suspicious and red. Hey, let's see what's in it. Sorry, but that's not possible. It's locked. Darn, I wanted to see what's inside. So what do you think, my dear beauty? Do you really think we can trust this deal? Who knows? It's not our job to think about that. But those incidents did happen in this country, just as you predicted. Yes, and they were pretty amusing too, weren't they? That fellow who sang out national secrets during the live TV broadcast, and the man who laid siege to the Metro Police Department, taking the top dog hostage. But what if he double-crossed it? It wouldn't be pretty. No, no, he needs his deal too. And we've accepted all his conditions as well. Yes, and thanks to that, we have to be here on this extra little assignment. But as long as I'm paired up with you, Beauty, I don't mind. How do they know about the cases at the special prison? Special prison? The guy who sang national secrets. The man who held siege to the Metropolis. Those cases are classified information. Huh, I've heard about both of those cases, and recently too. The perpetrators in those cases are being held in a special facility. That's what the special prison is, but it's not known about by the general public. So prisoner D99, Detective John, is one of these special cases too, huh? These two are talking about the very same cases I've heard about just tonight. It couldn't be coincidence, could it? Maybe it is. What's better, sweet potatoes or baked potatoes? Baked potatoes. Huh. What is it, Beauty? Why don't we move to a different spot? That table in the back looks good. Now you're talking, Beauty, my dear. Just what I've been waiting for. A quiet, secluded spot, just the two of us. I wouldn't object to that. All of a sudden, I'm getting this feeling somebody is eavesdropping. My sixth sense is very strong, you know? That's alright, my dear. You don't have to make excuses. Off we go, across the bridge of poultry to the land of love. No, let me go to the chicken! Oh my god. What just happened? Did she sense we were here? Wait, what? With her sixth sense? Haha. But you know, I have some pretty amazing powers myself. Yeah, like what? Dying? Like if there's chicken nearby, I can tell right away. That's called a sense of smell. But anyway, at least the situation has changed a little bit. I don't believe in the sixth sense. It's not scientific. Sister Gold. But come to think of it, we've been left behind, haven't we? It looks that way. Not having legs is even more inconvenient than I thought it would be. But what are we going to do now? We are all the way over there. I'm telling you, we better get shake a leg, or we're gonna miss what they're saying. It'll be pretty hard to shake a leg not having legs and all. This reminds you of Boris and Natasha from Rocky and Bullwinkle? I never heard of that. They're still talking about something. I want to hear. Me too. Thank you. Oh. So I was wondering, we're not stuck over here by any chance, are we? We might just be. Okay, well, I have two thoughts. Number one, if we want to get over to where those two are, we have to use this red truck they forgot somehow. Sounds about right. What's your other thought? It doesn't look like this blue-haired bartender could be much help. So I guess we have to find somebody who can help then. Well, looks like the waitress. Hey, look, we got a new glass. You rang? Oh, I get it. You saw that couple over there and you started to get lonely, right? And so you decided to call me? Oh, that's so sweet. Forgive me, but I didn't ring for anybody. What? Now, could you not stand in my light, please? I can't see my glass properly. I've been working here for 2 days, and I've been waiting this whole time for you to notice me. Now, will you stop trying to shake me up and just stick to shaking cocktails? She has a surprisingly short career with this place. Oh, you just broke that glass. Just like you did my heart. A broken glass can never be put back the way it was. Just leave it there. You can't just leave it. Somebody might get hurt. Doesn't this trunk belong to the couple over there? The only thing we allow customers to lose here are their cares. Miss, please go and let them know about the trunk, if you would be so kind. How gallant of you. I just might fall for you, you know? Blood girl. I agree. Me too. Oh, but I can't reach the bag now. Fudge! I've been working here for 2 days, and I have the eyes on you the whole time. I think this might be my last night working here, though. It's been fun. I guess she's leaving this place with her surprisingly short career intact. Whoops. Of all things to forget, it wouldn't have been pretty if I forgot this. Here we are, finally. I feel kind of bad though, eavesdropping the... Not me. I mean, we just delivered their lost trunk to them after all. They owe us at least this much. What kind of detective says something like that? I can't believe I forgot the trunk, whole thing. With such a small body, you probably only have a small brain to match. Oof, that hurts. Beauty, but that's okay. That's what I love about you. That's what he loves about her? I don't get it either. Now, where were we? All right, who did invite to the wedding? If we got married, of course. Haha. We can talk about that when we're alone. Huh? But aren't we alone now, Beauty? Huh. Do you think she senses our presence again? I spy a ladybug. A ladybug? I just hate little bugs. What? After all that trouble, it happened anyway? It looks that way, yes. It's not over yet, though. It's not? What are you talking about? You're not dead yet. No, but I'm gonna be in just a few seconds. But before that happens, maybe there's something we can do from here. Hello? Looks like he's unconscious. Excuse me, but could you wake up for a second, please? Pushy as ever, this detective. One thing I've learned is that the newly dead stay unconscious for a little while at first. Huh? I saw like that. It was like that. And you were like that too. Oh yeah, I guess you're right. Anyway, if we restart the flow of time now, you'll die. Yeah, I know. Why don't we try going back even further in time? Oh, what? Even further? But how? Simple. We go back 4 minutes before the death of this poor driver here. Small shaming feels bad for short men. What do you mean? Hey, Wabi, how are you? Riku, dance, hello. I never tried it before. So I don't know how it'll go. But if we can erase the driver's death, that should erase your death too. Oh wow. I can't think of any other way. Let's try it. What the? Lynn, our rookie detective. What's she doing at point X? Could it be just a coincidence? And we just got an APB on her a little while ago. Something about an extremely important case, an extremely important witness, currently extremely on the run. Now what? Should I report this to Inspector Cavanella? Oh, he did! I'm doing alright, Wabi. She told us to stay off the radio unless it was an emergency, but I think I better call this in. Poor Lynn. I wonder what she did this time. Inspector Cavanella is pretty protective when it comes to Lynn. He'd want to know. What's the matter? Alright, fine. Wait, who did he talk to? This is point X. Idiot. Oh, this is the... Yeah, this is the guy. Static is awful. I can't believe I forgot the trunk. Of all things. With such a small body. Oh, so it was bug. So then she destroyed the bug. Ouch, that hurts. But that's okay. That's what I love about you. What the heck is this? I spy a ladybug. A ladybug? I just hate little bugs. I can't hear very well. Oh, and if he... Oh, wow. Wow, okay. Oh, the van driver was a detective. It looks like it. I noticed something though. That conversation he was listening to just before the crash? I remember hearing it before. You're right. We just heard it a few minutes ago, didn't we? Just after the conversation, the detective suddenly passed out. What happened, I wonder? We already know what happened. We saw what happened in the restaurant. She burned up the ladybug. Sometimes when a high-tech bug like that is destroyed, it emits a loud signal. Loud enough to knock a person out if they were listening to it through headphones. So that's why the detective passed out, huh? Bingo! Now let's stop it from happening. I see. Hey, this place. This is the place that white suited inspector phoned tonight. This is the parking lot of the park out on the east side of town. It's been years. You know this park? Yeah, I used to play here a lot when I was little. But then one day, I swore I'd never set foot in this park ever again. Well, those are some really deep, dark feelings there. I wonder what happened. Hold it. Don't give me that a ghost doesn't have a foot to set with. It's just a figure of speech. What kind of nitpicker do you think I am? Anyway, whatever. Let's get started. Okay, let's do that. I won't press her about that other thing for now. What other thing? Wait, what? Oh, I didn't. Brrr. I missed the conversation in his mind. That's it, a rookie detective. Oh, okay. They put an APB on me? Apparently, they're calling you a fugitive. You naughty girl, you. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to make you upset. A girl's heart is a very delicate thing, you know? This from the girl a giant chicken couldn't even kill. It did kill me. What do they mean this time? Mind your own business. I like to do things my way, okay? What are these doing here? Oh shit! Okay, we're going to the phone. Detective Ridge, this is Memory. What's the matter? It's not time for your regular report. Listen to this. There's a suspicious couple on the bar upstairs. I'm going to put a ladybug on them. A ladybug? You mean a listening device? Don't do anything to blow our cover. Inspector Carbonella will be furious. But they're doing all kinds of suspicious whispering. We have to find out what he's saying. You can pick up the signal from your van. Check out the conversation for me, would you? Alright, fine. Once you get something... Once you keep going on something, I know there's no stopping you. Thanks. Later then. Hold on. Did you see a customer come in just now? A young woman with red hair and red boots? Oh yeah, that. That restless suspicious chick, sure. Suspicious? I mean, come on. As soon as she sat down, she ordered 3 glasses of water in a row. And she spilled the second glass on the table. Okay, fine. Keep your eye on her too, if you would. You got it. Oh wow, that waitress. She was an undercover agent. And she apparently thought you were pretty suspicious too. Oh yeah, sorry. I was really thirsty, huh? So you know. No, I don't. Anyway, did you hear what I heard about the listening device? We have to do something about that bug. So should we stay here or follow up on the waitress? Looks like it's time to make a decision. I say we stay. Should we stay? I think we stay. I'm worried about that detective memory. After all, they call her the Lynn of the Special Investigation Unit. I see. Well, well, did you hear that, detective? At least it's better than me being called the memory of the detective division. In any rate, I better report to Inspector Caminello before I worry about that listening device. What's the leaflet for? Okay, so he's gonna go get her. All the way from the beginning? No way. Oh my god. So we gotta go to the phone. Go to her. Oh, Aragon, thank you for the 28 years. Also, do you guys hear there's going to be a Scott Pilgrim show coming? I'm so excited for it. Thank you, Aragon. Yeah, look where we are. Huh? The heart of the chicken kitchen, eh? I know, I'm so happy. What if it's bad? Then I'll be sad. But I don't. It, so far from the trailer, it looked good. So far from the trailer. Yeah, it's made by Lucas Lee, I think. I know, what's his name? The guy who created the show. So it should be okay? Should? Who knows? Yep, or as most people say, the kitchen. I hope the key to preventing this accident is here somewhere. Oh, I bet it will be. You know what they say. Where there's smoke and chicken, there's fire. Well, now that you mention it, it is pretty smoky in here. What's wrong? I can't seem to raise the switch, it won't budge. Yeah, well, not surprising considering this whole place is sticky with grease. I bet it must be stuck. Yeah, it does feel pretty sticky. But if the switch were already raised, I bet I could manage to lower it. Let's see. Ah. Interesting t-shirt. Hey, look what she's doing. Do you think that could be... Yeah, she's probably finding the ladybug. Now that I think about it, it's this waitress railing that starts the whole chain of events. The detective wouldn't have gotten his ears blown out and wouldn't have crashed. In other words, we're witnessing it with our own eyes. The cause of a huge disaster, slowly being planted in a chicken. Hey, I just had a good idea. About what to do with the ladybug? No, I was thinking we could let her get crushed under the chicken instead of me. I can't tell if you're kidding. At any rate, now we've seen the root cause of the accident. And all we have to do now is think of a way to take care of it. What do you mean? What? Sounds good to me. It's smoking here. Oh, those are ventilation fans? Okay. Oh, yeah, it's a bottle of... Hey, what's up with this lazy Susan? It's acting up today. Maybe it's out of sorts because I was spinning around on it yesterday. Interesting thing to do for a lady her age. Maybe it's out of sorts? How about thinking maybe it might be broken? But it really isn't broken. It's just a skill. Oh, I see what's gonna happen. We're gonna have to swap it around. Okay. What are you doing? I could tell. I thought I'd give it a little spin. Oh, I get it. You're trying to get in the way of her planting that ladybug. Get in there. But it just seems to be making her all the more determined. I guess this isn't gonna work. Well, I see what's happening. There we go. Let me spin it. There we go. They're all set. There, how about that? The lever is still sitting on the table. We did it. chicken. Thou art so beautiful, chicken. I took a bite, my heart swelled with pride, and I got goosebumps. What the heck is this? I'm consumed with the love of consuming you, la la la. Hey Screwball, how are you? Hope you've been doing well. Long time no see. Well, it looks like you've escaped your fate of being hammered by your horrible hand. Yes, but I still haven't escaped the worst darkness of this terrible night. I shot you, didn't I? It must have been some sort of complicated set of circumstances that made you do it. It's never okay to shoot a person, no matter how hot the circumstance. How are you, Scribble? Hope you've been doing well. Super busy with work is a good thing. What do you mean? Yeah, busy with work is a good thing. It's never okay to shoot a person, no matter what the circumstances. Hey, shouldn't that be my line? But anyway, you were investigating a case, and I was supposed to give you information on that case. Maybe it's time you told me about it. Tell me about the case you were looking into. Yeah, I guess I should. Well, let's go back to the new present first. Okay, sure. Ooh, fishing. What do you fish? Back in the new present, the delicious aroma of chicken fills the air, but I'm still thinking about Lynn. I wonder if she's still waiting for her chicken to be served. I decided to go see her. See her and ask her the questions that were still consuming me. Seems like all the good weather is during the day to work. Damn. The disastrous accident has been completely erased. Once again, I saved the red-headed detective from death. Saved Lynn, the criminal who stole my life. One question in particular hangs heavy on my mind. Why did she shoot me? Until I know the answer, I'll never be satisfied. Oh my god, look at her eat. Meanwhile, Lynn's appetite is apparently foremost in her mind. A golden brown chicken sits on her table in front of her. Until she eats the whole thing, she'll probably never be satisfied. Yeah, why don't you just eat it? Is Lynn having a serious talk with that detective? Nah, she's just gulping down chicken. How did the detectives know to stake out this restaurant tonight? I better see if I can get some information. But more importantly, I have lots of questions for the lady detective. Oh, I didn't know you were here, Detective Ridge. Come to see me, did you? Aw, that's so sweet. Oh, hi, Memory. Don't mind us. Just pretend we're not here. Why don't you try some chicken while you're here? No thanks. Just watching Lynn eat is quite enough for me. So, how did it turn out with my ladybug? Oh, the listening device? Well, let's see. I thought the gentleman had a very nice singing voice. Sorry, but we're in the middle of an important talk. Could you leave us to it? But you guys are the ones who called me over. Huh. Hot girl. I agree. Me too. What? She's talking to the other detective quietly while she stops her face. But I'm too far away to hear what did she say. I better get closer. How? Face doesn't taste good? Really? Didn't you decide you want some chicken or me after all? We didn't call you. Sorry, but could you give us some privacy? No, stay right there. Uh-huh. I'm at a crucial moment here with this chicken. Okay. I need you to pour me some water if it starts going down wrong. Liz, you don't have to risk your life over chicken, you know. He's right. Look at her attacking that thing. Anyway, I better move now while I still have a chance. Oh yeah. Is he gonna eat her out? I don't know. Oh, that's funny. Even though I just saved this detective, he doesn't have a core. Not like the one Lin has, or that valiant little doggy missile. I thought the ones I saved are supposed to develop a core when they are alive again. I guess I still have things to learn about these powers of the dead. Well, I'm heading back. Lots of things to do, you know. Yeah, like washing dishes and planting bugs. Someday I'll plant a big one on you, detective. If I do eat fish, it's usually the walleye or pickerel. I never heard of those. Archer, I agree. Me too. Listen, Lin. You explained your side, but and I understand, but there's an APB out on you. Can't you at least hurry up and get out of here? You know, slip away quietly. No can do. I'm meeting somebody here. Meeting someone. Oh yeah, that's right. The little lady, Camilla. But why do you have to meet somebody here? The special investigation unit is watching this restaurant now. How can that be a coincidence? I don't know, but it is a coincidence. Hey, is it true what they say, that you are still looking into Detective Joe's case on your own? Inspector Campanella is worried about you, you know? I understand how you feel, but just don't do anything crazy, okay? I think so. I think so, Captain. So how's that chicken you've been waiting so long for? It's great. But you know, with Detective Ringe, that's his name, by the way, sitting right across from me. I mean, he was just dead a few moments ago, right? Just kind of talking to the... That's kind of taking the edge off my appetite. Oh, brother. But he's a great guy. He understands my situation, he said. Am I gonna be streaming Starfield? I think so. I think I'll be playing Starfield, yes. It looks really good. I like space games. And that does make me very intrigued. I need to watch more videos on it though. Like what Starfield is, how is it working, see maybe more demo about it. To test that game? That's true, but still, I'll take a gamble on it. He's going to give me a pass, just for tonight. Speaking of Detective Ridge, I noticed something strange. He doesn't have a core now. He doesn't? I thought a core was supposed to show up once I saved somebody. Huh. When you possessed his core, he was unconscious, right? Unconscious? Yeah, he was, wasn't he? Just like you. You were unconscious the first time I saved you too. And after I saved you, you didn't have a core either. So for people who are unconscious when you save them, no core shows up. I think that's probably what it is. You might be right. Okay, I'll leave Ridge to you then. But I still have a lot of questions for you. Yeah, I thought you would. Let's get started then. Death Row Inmate Joe. Bethesda games are usually good, especially by the main developers. I don't know. They have a bad reputation lately.
But at the same time, I have hope.
Petro inmate Joe. What is your connection with prisoner D99, Detective Joe? He seems like more than just a co-worker. Yeah, I suppose you have the right to know. Detective Joe is my hero. Hero, huh? You don't hear that word much anymore. Well, it's an old-fashioned hero-y kind of story. It happened 10 years ago. Now just calm down and drop that weapon. Stay back. If you come any closer, I'll shoot her. Is that a redhead girl? On that day 10 years ago, I was playing in my favorite park. And then, suddenly, somebody grabbed my arm from behind. I was so scared. I thought I was gonna die. And then... he appeared. Detective Joe. Visor games, whether considered good or not, were usually considered very janky and buggy. I think the last Bethesda game Todd developed was Fallout 4, and I liked that game. Fallout 4 wasn't that good, was it? I tried it, it was alright. Hey, Dragon Lord! All the bugs are features? Yeah, Fallout 76 got a lot of, cockroaches, right? Game-breaking ones at that, and ones that it basically come down to the modding community coming along to fix it. Isn't it surprising? People working for free, fixing things that... that, you know... I mean, to be fair, Bethesda is a small indie company, right? Skyrim was painfully broken and buggy, especially on the PS3 and 4. It hit the point of the class action. Well, wasn't Skyrim meant for PC anyways? So I wouldn't be surprised if it's already broken for PC. PlayStation 3 and 4 is gonna be worse. Oh yeah, I heard Raidfall was pretty trash. Hi-Fi Rush was good though, yes, you're right. Ghostwire Tokyo kind of fall off the radar pretty fast. Deathloop went on sale pretty early. Doom Eternal I heard was really good. Wolfenstein fell off the map as well. Fallout 76 was... We all know about that. Hey, Darbies! Yeah, my Skyrim bugs were funny though. It didn't really break the game. Yeah, it didn't break the game, but it break immersion, which is pretty bad. And then that really loud sound. I think it was the sound of a gun. I passed out. But when I came to... You're all right now. Are you hurt? You saved me, mister? I was just doing my job. The gods. They are the ones who saved you. What's your job, mister? Me? I'm a police detective. So that's why you became a detective, huh? That's right. He was my ideal of what a detective was all about. But an ideal detective doesn't shoot and kill his own wife. Exactly. And that's why I don't... And that's why I want to prove he didn't do it. Oh, I see, Captain. How are you, Darbies? How are you? Here's a problem with that. Bethesda Bethesda has long shown such a thing for Microsoft Xbox from the get-go that they failed miserably in getting a good porting crew or learning to make games. Yeah. I mean, to be fair, they have Skyrim. Why would they want to make more money? It's printing money. Detective Ridge works for the Special Investigation Unit. He said an important deal is set to go down here tonight at this restaurant. A deal that could affect the future of our nation. A nation isn't something that's easily influenced though. But that's what he said. Anyway, it's a couple at the table upstairs. I hear they're foreigners. They're waiting for the other party in this deal to show up now. Those two, huh? They certainly are an odd pair. Is this other party they're waiting for me? It's kind of hard to imagine, isn't it? No one really knows any of the details of this deal, except for one person. Mr. Breezy Dancer in a white suit. They say he's been watching the movements of those two for a long time. I've never seen him work so frantically on an investigation before. Inspector Cabanella, eh? Apparently you're a real favorite of his. A favorite? Yes, well, there's a reason for that. And what's that? Inspector Cabanella and Detective Joad were good friends. Yeah, I think I remember the prison guard saying something about that. They joined the detective division the very same day. They're two very different types, but they were always in friendly competition to do the best. Detective Joe was always very particular about thorough investigation of a crime scene. And Inspector Cabanella, well, I guess he just has a natural genius for investigating. Anyway, those two lead the detective division in those days. But Inspector Cabanella is different now. He changed a little. He changed? Ever since the Detective Joad incident, now he distances himself from fieldwork, and he's starting to focus on nothing but moving up the ladder. Huh. And so that's how he became head of the Special Investigation Unit, I take it. Are you seriously considering Vanessa games are bad though? They're well, all well, I wouldn't say all well received, but they are definitely, there's definitely some good and some received better and some received worse. It also depends on what type of games you like, right? Taka. That's all about money. Overall, no, but I was a game dev student, so I learned and studied and did some modding. Oh, nice. I don't know where this revision stuff comes from. Where though? I wouldn't say they suck, but I say they could be better. It depends on which game you're talking about. Because you were the little girl his good friends had saved, huh? He really looked out for me, helping me study for my detective exam, fudging my exam scores for me. That goes a little beyond the scope of looking out for you. Inspector Cabanella, eh? I wonder what role he plays in everything that's happening tonight. Wait, New Vegas wasn't Bethesda, right? If I remember right, New Vegas was another company. Was it Bethesda? I don't remember. Not sure on Xbox, but I remember for PC, because most for the. But for Oblivion, if you got Vampirism, you could only do it while having the base game, you couldn't. I see. So technically it's not Bethesda. Camilla. It sure is taking Camilla long enough. She should have been here by now. I'm getting really worried. You two are like sisters, aren't you? That's what Camilla said. Yep, that's about sums it up. It doesn't look like being worried affected your appetite much though. Hey, the bigger the crisis, the more girls gotta eat. I have to make sure Camilla stays safe, no matter what. Camilla. And that music box, too. Music box? Oh yeah, that wooden box. That box was a present from Detective Joad. From Detective Joad? Yes. It was 5 years ago. That box arrived 3 days after the murder incident. He must have sent it just before he was arrested. Someday, when the case is over and everything is settled, I want you to give this to the certain person, he said. So what's inside? I don't know. I can't open it. Huh, that's a shame. Sissel, I... Did I really shoot you? Where did that come from, out of the blue? I really don't remember. I tried and tried, but I just can't. Now I finally understand how you must feel, and how hard it is to have your memory gone. So your story erased. But who knows, knowing the truth might be even harder. I'd rather believe there's hope myself. That was great. Does Lynn as a child? Oh, just now, yeah. How old is Lynn? I don't know, 16, 18, 21? So typical shareholders want results now. Does anyone actually think Outer Worlds was better than... I don't know. Never played Outer Worlds. Isn't Obsidian now owned by Bethesda? Seems like it. If she was 8 in the flashback, I guess she's 13. It's legal. This is a Japanese game. Do I have chicken on my face? You're staring. I bet you're thinking about how impressed you are with the way I took care of that chicken. Just tell me one thing. This case you say you're looking into, is it Detective Jones? What if it was? I can't keep it from you. It's too cruel. Huh? Well, what are you talking about? I'm sorry, Lynn. It is tonight. Detective Jones, you know, is tonight. His execution. But there's still time. I looked into it, and I found out all the executions. And I found out all the executions in this country are carried out at dawn. That may be the norm, but not this time, I'm afraid. What? The execution is set for 11 p.m. What did you say? It's gonna happen pretty soon. Isn't there anything we can do to stop it? Of course not. It's too late now. Not without a stay of execution from the Justice Minister. I'm gonna see him then. What? See who? Who else? The Justice Minister. Don't be ridiculous. There's not enough time. I'm going. Sissel. Me? Get to the prison. Stop the execution. Easy enough for you to say. Detective Ridge, I'll be going now. Okay, I'll let you go this time. I'll tell him I was distracted because I was eating chicken. Is there anything else I can do? Did you find Camilla? She's supposed to be on her way here. Oh, your little Camilla? Okay, you got it. I'll look for her. Okay, you know what to do, Sissel. You have to save Detective Joe. The life of yet another person I'm connected to somehow is about to end tonight. Could it be just another coincidence, or is there something more behind it all? Detective Jord is destined to be executed tonight. I don't know if that fate is the wrong one for him or the right one, but I've decided to go to the prison anyway. Alright. Let me read chat. You guys are active all of a sudden. I'm interested. What are we talking about here? You're interested in... You're excited for Armored Core 6 personally? I love the massive customization option. Yeah, I might play that too. I don't know. What is TES6? You're not even shooting a Bethesda, you hope Starfield with the money that Microsoft makes it great, but I feel like after Skyrim, their games are getting more and more stale. That's what I'm worried about. I do hope Starfield becomes great. I hope, I don't. Elder Scrolls 6, I see. You see, the thing is, Bethesda kind of made a reputation for themselves for not making good games. That's why when Hi-Fi Rush was published, I didn't get it immediately because I was like, huh, it is a Bethesda game, sort of. But it was really good. Right? The funny thing about Starfield, I finally am getting a new GPU, and what am I getting? A free code? Wait, what? You're getting a free code? You don't want it? Well, if you don't want it, my DMs are open. I'm just saying. They're known for buggy ass games. Yeah, that's the thing, right? They have a reputation for themselves. A free Starfield code? Well, if it's free, it's for me. I'm just saying. I just always thought the games suck. I live in an era where I could rent games, and every single Armored Core game I rented just sucked. I never played any Armored Core games, so, you know, I wouldn't know. Free game is infinite value, right? Only get it when I install and register a GPU. Wait. Do they give you the code or do you just get to play it right away? Yeah, I never played any Armored Core, so I wouldn't know at all. Don't know a thing about it. Oh, I need some background music. Let me find some good background music. I think I know one. I know a good one. This is a good background song, I think. There we go. That's a good background. All right, everyone, we're talking about games now. Perfect, perfect, wonderful, wonderful. You give Armored Core franchise too many chances, but it was just bad. Are they really, though? I heard a lot of people like it. Your best advice is wait for the full release, wait for a few days after the review beginning of the game and see whether you like it or not. But Taka, as a streamer, I gotta be ahead of the curve, you know? I gotta be like the beta testers. I gotta be like right in there. You think they don't spit scribble skulls? I mean, everyone have a different game interest, right? Like, for example, I like Final Fantasy 14 because one, it has Lalafells, two, it has Nanamo, three, it has Tataru, four, it has Kryle, and five, it has Raiden, right? Put those five together, you got a good game. But for some people, they like World of Warcraft. You can pay extra to play Starfield early. Wait, how do you pay early for it? Is there like early access? I don't suggest beta testing. You'll be playing the same games over and over. Yeah, right? I pay to play early and work for them for free. Yeah, that's not happening. I will do beta testing if it's free, but I will not do it. To, yeah. You buy the super special edition or whatever you oh, 5 days early? Yeah, okay. A month early, I'll consider. 5 days is fine. You like Final Fantasy 14 for your Ori and Vera? No! Lalafells, they're the better race. To be honest, the people that made Armored Core are not the same now. FromSoft blew up since then and have more money and are bigger. Since Armored Core 5, they released one average game. Yeah, that's great. Some people like Dark Souls too. Some. $70 for the late access, $100 for 5 days. 5 days. So $30 for 5 days. $6 a day. That's crazy. That's like one tonkatsu every day. My only issue is I don't know if my graphic card will be alive to play that game. Starfield. I think I need to mod my graphic card. I need to put like those copper plates or something to help the cooling for my graphic card because I think my graphic card is overheating. Okay, the level in PvP map. Listen, no one plays Dark Souls for PvP, all right? Well, Scribble, you're not wrong. I mean, you're entitled to your opinion. I never played any Armored Core, so I have no, what do you call it? I have no opinion on it. I know they have some PvP fanatic. That's why they're called fanatics, right? You know, saying it was great, but it wasn't like Saturday night Taco Bell garbage. I see. I didn't know I didn't know there was such a label. Like she barely cared about the story, she just rushed to get it to the PvP. Yeah, I'm not a PvP person. So I'm not gonna say your opinion is wrong, just that there are different opinions. Yeah, that's the best way to look at it. Everyone has a different opinion of games, right? I like Lalafells in my Final Fantasy 14. But there are people who go like, Lalafells shouldn't exist in Final Fantasy 14. And I'm like, that's your opinion. They're keeping it cleanish. It is cleanish. Ish. But clean. And like some people doesn't like Resident Evil is. It's great at the same time. And then we have Junior. Also, hi Pack Lord. How are you? Why is there no audio for the raid? Interesting. How are you, Pack Lord? Thank you for the raid. She can defend the lolly because she must defend her own. The people that just say Lalafell should not exist and aren't joking. They are, sadly. How's it going? It's going all right. The stream has turned into a just chatting stream, but we did good progress on the game. I think we are on chapter 8. We're halfway through this game. This game is interesting, but it's a bit slow. It was interesting. I like it, but it's slow. Did you see some Animal Crossing gameplay? I played Animal Crossing. What do you mean, Junior? Good progress up to now? No, it's good progress regardless. Armored Core? No, I did not. I did not see anything. Not yet. I should. Because Yoshi P got class, that's why. I was thinking about tactics, but if I were to play that, I'd rather play Ogre Tactics, right? Can't wait for Monster Hunter now. When is it coming out? Or is it already out? I don't think it's out, is it? Put like 100 tactic Easter egg in P12S? Bullshit. Hopefully never. August 28th. August 28th is not that long. It's like literally 10 days. Or 12 days for you guys. Ay-yi-yi. So many games, so little time. There's like Lies of P, Armored Core, Starfield. What are the games that I have to play? Armored Core? Starfield? Too many games. Too many games. Oh! Yeah, Lies of P, Starfield. Oh my gosh. You have to show me a screen by screen screenshot, Junior. Cyberpunk DLC. I don't think I'll ever play Cyberpunk again. Sadly. At least Kena's off the list, right? Right? You never tried Lies of P? I think the demo is still available, Dragon Lord. Try the demo. If you like Bloodborne, you will like Lies of P. Taka, I don't think you added to the backlog. I think you added to the plan the games to play. AC6 is my least priority. Lies of P and Starfield are my top priority. AC6 are less. Cyberpunk was the largest broken release. Yeah, I was hyped up like crazy and was broken at the start. Alright, Junior, I'm looking. What do you mean? These look cute. You want to die to these things, Junior. What are you talking about? That's Ultima, look. If that's Ultima, you want to die to that Ultima, okay? My neck is gonna break one day. Cyberpunk is still an empty shell of a game of broken promises. Yeah, I mean, Cyberpunk is a very pretty game, but it's a very broken game. I think CD's Project board realized that they should just let the team do their work. You think so? I think the game is already screwed. Actually, I'm curious. Are people still playing that game? Let me see real quick. Cyberpunk 2077. Let me see Twitch. Wait, it's quite a healthy. It's not bad. There are people playing it still. Yeah, there's still people playing Cyberpunk. That's pretty okay. Oh, well, Edge Run is kinda. Some perks and buffs don't work right, but at least it's. Yeah. It's mostly functioning, but things still don't end. I don't know if they ever will. Oh, Martyrs? We'll see. The company has had a reputation of solid games, minimal bugs, and high quality, and then this came around. Cybercrack. From what I understand, they made some major improvements to it and have fixed nearly everything. But people like me will never go back to Cyberpunk, only because I finished the game. Unfortunately, Square hasn't learned from FF15. I never played FF15. What's wrong with it? You disagree with Cyberpunk being minimal bugs, people forget the unplayable mess Witcher 3 was at launch, but they at least fixed that game. They broke Witcher 3 with some patch, didn't they? You never go back due to PTSD? I never go back because I'm done with the story. Not even an expansion? Nope. To me, Cyberpunk story has ended. The story wasn't exciting to me. So... I don't know. Nah, you're gonna go back to Elden Ring. Yeah, I'll see you. I don't think so. Elden Ring, I already uninstalled it. I don't think I'll ever do it again. By trying to fix some exploit, the game kind of broke, but hey. Some exploit were fixed for the 1% using it, and 95% game is worse now. I fixed the problem with this patient. His heart was weak, so I removed it. I fixed it. Final Fantasy 15 got railroaded hard and forced to come to a climax fast, and all the other expansions canceled that would have given a proper ending. Okay, point is, at least the company fixed it, took the hit, and not the here you go, fix it yourself and buy our stuff and what. True. You think Chica would like for 15, but she would still find flaws. I mean, there's always going to be flaws in every game. Even Final Fantasy 14, there are flaws. The flaws are the stupid players. That's the flaw. You find Chica is easily pleased if there's a cinematic feel to the game? Yes and no. I have complaints about Final Fantasy 16. Only doing a party so Chica will probably enjoy Final Fantasy 15. Listen. Like what for 16? Okay. Final Fantasy 16, my biggest gripe about it is the side quest really breaks the flow of the game. That's the really, 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 really big thing for me. If 16 was just the main story, if Final Fantasy 16 was just the main story, like fluidly all the way, it would have been pretty good. But at the same time, without the side quest, you won't understand the world enough. But pacing wise, I don't know how they will have to fix it, because the side quest complements the main quest. But forcing yourself to do the side quest breaks the flow of the pacing of the game. That's the only issue I had. Sixteen. I'm trying to play through the end, and the end is, from what I heard, the same bullshit from other titles. Okay, Dragon Lore. I only played 4 Final Fantasies: Final Fantasy 9, Final Fantasy 7 Remake, Final Fantasy 14, and Final Fantasy 16. So those are the only 4 I've played. So I can't say the same bullshit, but so far. Based off of 9 and 15, they don't seem the same at all. I should play 10, but 10 is about the K-pop girls, isn't it? Also, hi, Elwinder, again. Did you laugh at Vivi's death? I didn't laugh at Vivi's death. I just don't understand what's so great about Vivi. Will I play Final Fantasy 15? I doubt. If 16 used the 7R system with the ATV, it would have been better than their cooldown system.
I wouldn't mind. I don't mind 16's fighting style though. It's just the only problem with 16's fighting style is it's just a what do you call it? It's nothing special about it. Like you choose a fighting style and that's the fighting style you're going to go with from start to the end of the game. That's the only issue. There is no incentive for you to switch it up. I never played 13 Hour Winner. I don't know. Coil Lightning Return. Qwalby is Qwalby plays Black Mage. His opinion don't matter. No, I'm kidding. Then proceeds not to use abilities until the enemies are staggered? Yes. I think the balancing in 16 is not good. Chico will love Xenoblade, but listen. You only say I like Xenoblade because it has the cat girl and the two booba girls. Right? You only say I like Xenoblade because Mia is there. You say Xeno Saga, but no one wants to go through a game where the first 3 to 4 hours of gameplay is pretty much all cutscene. Dragon Lord, I would do that. I like cutscenes. Nia is pretty amazing, I agree. Nia with her British accent, damn, makes me want to have that British accent, you know? Thirteen was okay. 13-2, okay, maybe. Like no real reason to exist. Lightning Return should be deleted from history. Damn. I mean, you like Final Fantasy 14 because of Lalafells. Why not? I mean, Nia is technically a cat girl, though. Dragon Lord, but I like cutscenes. Like, I wish Final Fantasy 16 has longer cutscenes, personally. I never played Xenoblade 2. You like good cutscenes? Oh, okay. Listen, Final Fantasy 16 cutscenes, I mean, the beach cutscene could be a little longer, you know? You know what I mean? Play God of War if you'll enjoy cutscenes, but I have to play God of War 1, right? God of War 1, 2. Could we show more? Nah, we want longer cutscenes. God of War 1 is cheap on PS4 or 5. If Xenoblade was on PC, you could mod, hack all the cores. Listen, if Xenoblade 2 was on PC, we're gonna mod other things. Like the onsen scene is gonna be like less misty. You know what I mean? I'm not saying anything. I'm just saying. Only Xenoblade did a fan service. It's too late. It's too late. Replace the dwarf main character for a naked hot chick. Wait, Xenoblade 2? I thought Xenoblade 2 main character was the boy.
Wait, 0B3 has Mia as well? You, it's grown up Mia. We don't want a grown up Mia. Get rid of that Mia. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think I will play Xenoblade. I see. So I guess he has to sheath his swords, huh? Bro, there's a dude, Ricky. He gets a robot as a weapon and she looks like a tomboy. Go check out how she looks and find out if there's too much fan service in that game. Ricky. Who's Ricky? Alright, Xeno. Wait, hold on. Xenoblade, Ricky, robot. What am I looking at? What am I looking for? Final upgrade. Yeah, I see the potato, but I'm not sure what I'm looking for. Poppy Cutie? Oh my god, what a stupid name, but okay. Poppy Cutie Xenoblade? I'm seeing fan arts. Where's the game? Game. Alright. She doesn't look that bad. I've seen worse, but she doesn't look that bad. She doesn't look that bad. Nintendo is thirsty? Nintendo just wants your money. Whatever sells works. The only thing Nintendo is not doing is releasing a newer Switch because the Switch is so old now. God damn it. The Switch is like, oh my god. I wish I would be playing more Pokemon Unite if it wasn't so laggy on the stupid Switch. Also, never underestimate people's thirst. If I recall right, there was a breakthrough in Blender animation because people... There was breakthrough in Blender animation because of people's thirst. Wait, what? Do I want to know? What character in Bioshock? Obviously the little girl, right? Oh, they added Mewtwo to Pokemon Unite. Sad. Sad. Aragorn Criterion. Aragorn doesn't want to play with me. I told him let's play Criterion and he goes like, sure, oh, I'm disconnecting. Oh, disconnecting. And I was like, oh, okay. But yeah, guys, I would be playing. Okay, so there are three games that I'm planning to play that I will play. I will check out Starfield for sure.
I will play Lies of P when it comes out. So Lies of P for sure. Starfield, okay, wait, let me ask again. Is Starfield an MMO or is Starfield a multiplayer game? Which one is it? Is it like No Man's Sky? Like MMO? Starfield is a single player game. Okay. So Starfield is a single player game. I see. Then I don't know if I'll play. Lords of the Fallen? What's that? Lords of the Fallen. What is this? It's coming out October? But what is it? Lies of P, Talia? Yeah, playing Palia is fun. Oh, do I want to play Palia? Okay, tomorrow I don't stream, right? But if I do stream tomorrow, we're trying Palia. Okay? Tomorrow I don't stream, but if I do stream, we're gonna check out Palia. Let's see what Palia is all about. Yeah, it's free to play. A lot of people have co-op, like real co-op, and all the ner soul nerds like it. What about Remnant 2? People are saying Remnant 2 was pretty good as well. Ba-ka-ba-ka-pow! It's not the same. Too many games, dude. Remnant 2, Palia, Lies of P, Starfield, Armored Core 6. What other games are coming out? Too many games. Too many games. Lord of the Fallen coming out in October. How did people like it since it's pretty much a beta alpha at this point? I need song. Time to install Palia? You're right. I have to install Palia after this. If you play Remnant, I'll play you too, but it's so expensive right now. I'm playing on PC, yes. Actually, I'll install it now. Let's see. Google Palia. Is it even out on Switch? Oh shit, I have to sign up. You install tomorrow, you're already in bed? What do you mean, Aragon? You can't be in bed yet. What? Too much time gating? How else to get you to continue to play it? But Aragon, we're going to go to Criterion after this. What do you mean?
And when you craft planks and coal bar, it takes minutes. Download the game. Download Palia Launcher. Next. Blah 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 blah. I agree, next. Okay, I'm installing Palia. So tomorrow, if I don't stream, if I stream, it'll be Palia. Okay? See? Okay? There we go. So Taka, Aragorn, Junior, Cap'n, Elwinder, and everyone else that I missed that's going, I think Jerry as well, playing Palia. You guys know what to do. Get your Palia. Get your Palia. Alright. Stream after 12 p.m. 1 p.m. I'll probably stream the same time like today. There's no lolly? Uninstall. Where's the uninstall button? Boring. Boring. But there's not enough violence in that game? There's not enough lolly. That's the most difficult part. Boring. Bad game. What is this? Waiting for Unreal Engine prerequisite install. Oh shit. I didn't see this. I was waiting for nothing. There's a little girl with one leg spoilers, but okay. Spoilers, Captain. You spoiled the game. No point playing it anymore. Lolly image background? What? We talking about? Time to ban Cap'n? Yeah. How unfortunate. Throw away my pillow. Alright, so once again, thank you guys for hanging out with me today. It was a lot of cool discussion. I enjoyed it. Everyone was civil. That's the most important part. Everyone were respecting each other's opinion. That's the best part. So once again, thank you guys. Thank you guys for hanging out with me. Amazing just chatting gameplay. That's the thing about this game, right? Oh! Speaking of, I just remembered. I also have to play Sifu, right? Oh man, that's too many games! Wait! Sifu will be amazed, boss. Oh man. Also, what is Summoner Wars Chronicle? The art got me curious. Oh yeah, I need to play Baldur's Gate as well. Oh no! Too many games! Naraka Blade Point? Nah, I don't think I'll play that one. Sounds like a gacha? It's not a gacha. Okay. My new view camera? Wait. What do you mean? Am I gonna play Baldur's Gate? No, I don't think so. I'm curious about it, but I don't think so. Also, add it to my wish list, see? Add it. Baldur's Gate is good, but the gameplay is so slow that I find it's not gonna be good to watch. You think I'll be very salty about Baldur's Gate? Why? You like the new UI? Thank you, thank you. Arigatai gozaimasen. Wait, Baldur's Gate is hard? It's difficult? There's no way I can play Baldur's Gate with like. No way, Baldur's Gate is like I can play it with I can play no death in Baldur's Gate. What do you mean? No death Baldur's Gate, easy. I don't know what you're talking about. It can be hard, you said it that way? Psh, it's like real life. How hard can it be? Iron Man mode, tournament stage. Maybe. You think it depends? You're always picking fights? No, you always have to go with the skill of lies and intimidation. You just have to keep lying your way. Wait, I didn't clear Diablo 4. I didn't even play Diablo 4. I only played like the open beta. Doesn't count. Yeah, that's the problem, Jerry. That's the main problem I'm having. If one turn takes 30 minutes, it's gonna be so boring for stream. That's the only issue. That is the main reason why I don't want to play it. Like if one turn takes 30 minutes, oh. And imagine you played multiplayer. Like me waiting for Aragorn to plan his move takes 30 minutes? Oh. Are you saying you watch me play it? Oh look, it's reinstalled. That's crazy. What small game? That's why you'd be worried about Lies of P. Lies of P is gonna be an easy game. What are you talking about? Easy game, no-brainer game. Chigusa report Aragorn for slow playing. Yeah. I know when I played Mahjong in real life, every time when it reaches one player, that one player goes like, what do I play? We're like, oi, bus stop. Keep moving. The tiles are stopped. Keep moving. Listen. If I can finish Kena in hard difficulty, Lies of P is gonna be easy. Easy. All right. Right. Chica gotta go now. Chica gotta waiting on Sifu. When is the next sale for Sifu? That's the question. When is the potential sale? Let me check real quick. Google Steam, was it Steam DB? Was it? What is the next sale? Okay. Let's see. Press the wrong button. Sifu. SteamDB. What was the sale point again? How much was it? So it was 33% before. When was that? That was That was 2 weeks ago. Oh no, we missed it. Damn it. Well, that's unfortunate. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Well, that sucks. Unfortunate. Oh, I don't know about Vermintide, whatever that is. What other games do you guys want me to play again? Every 2 weeks. Wait, how do you see that? Come on. Oh, but we missed the sale though. Damn. Unfortunate. Would have played it. Elders. Why is Baldur's Gate so expensive? That's crazy. Palia? So expensive. Expensive! Games are expensive! Even no microtransaction. Is that left for it too? But with Warren? Oh. Eh! I don't know, Captain. Don't feel like buying too many games. It's okay. We'll play Palia tomorrow. The next sale of Sifu is when I'll play Sifu. I think that'll be good. Ring Fit Adventure? You know, Taka, yesterday I went for physiotherapy for my back. Apparently, my muscles are messed up. Well, not really, but they're weak. So, less sitting for me and more, you know, like stand up and exercise. That's what I have to do. I need to stand up and exercise more. That was the recommendation. But yeah, I think, it is time. It is time I abandon you guys for tomorrow. So with that said, thank you guys for hanging out with me. You guys have been awesome possum. What's RFA stream? Oh, Raiden Freak Adventure? Nah, it will happen. If I get two more trackers, I'll consider it again. I'm currently trying to fix my tracking. So instead of getting a new suit, I'm investing like 5% of a potential new suit into different tracking. So I'll see how it works out. I don't know if it's any better, but it's cheaper. But I don't know if it's any better. But we'll see. No, I didn't finish the game. Starship Troopers? Why does that game sound so familiar? Starship Troopers. No, I don't think I'll be playing this game. Nope. Nope. No, the stream was about 1 hour 45 minutes. Just chatting wasn't 1 hour 30 minutes. I know it's less than 1 hour because this Splatoon loop is only 30 minutes and it's been playing for 40 minutes. So, no. It's 1.5 hours of gameplay and no, 2 hours of gameplay and 45 minutes just chatting. You can't lie on that. I know my time. No, it's RE8 and maybe Callisto. But yeah. Alright, we're ending. Yeah, so wait, that's crazy. I don't know, Taka. It is what it is. So yeah, thank you guys. We will see after stream, like in 45 minutes, if we have enough for Criterion in Final Fantasy 14. Find out, but we'll see. But yes, thank you guys. Thank you for hanging out with me. Thank you for discussing. Tomorrow we're gonna play Palia if I stream. Once again, the game is installed. So, see? Installed. Alright. I hope this Palia game can be played with a controller though. But yeah. Thank you guys for hanging out. We are going to raid someone. Let's see who we raid in. Who are we raiding? Oh shit. Also, why is everyone playing Cyberpunk? Also, wait. Let's see. Gundam? I was thinking about it. Yep, Gundam sounds good. Alright, guys, you guys know Gundam by now? You guys have not been going through the raid. Go through the raid. Say hello to Gundam. He's an amazing friend. Alright? Say hello to them. Copy the raid message. Do say hello. Okay. Thank you guys for hanging out. Sorry again if you guys were looking for Ghost Trick and it ended up being a just chatting stream, but I was curious. Okay? So. Thank you guys for hanging out. Love you guys. Enjoy the music of Dawn. Dawn Trail, yeah. Yeah. Thank you. I'll catch you guys tomorrow if I do stream. But if I don't stream tomorrow, Ghost Trick Friday. I won't be late this time. Promise. Yes. Thank you guys. Love you guys. Bye bye. See ya, see ya.